Genesis 1:27-28, and Genesis 3:15-16. So if you have your Bible, please turn to that. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him. Male and female.
Well,
created he them. And God blessed them. And God said unto them, be fruitful and multiply and replenish the earth and subdue it. And have dominion over the fish of the sea and over the fowl of the air and over every living thing that moveth upon the earth. Now go to Genesis 3:15-16. And I will put enmity between thee and the woman, and between thy seed and her seed. It shall bruise thy head, and thou shalt bruise his heel. Unto the woman he said, I will greatly multiply thy sorrow and thy conception. In sorrow thou shalt bring forth children, and thy desire shall be to thy husband, and he shall rule over them. So this morning, if I had a subject to say, it would be the burden and blessing of evil.
All right.
Have you ever been served a full plate of food that contained several things you liked, but at least one item that you found distasteful? Did you find yourself picking around that distasteful item and eventually leaving them on your plate?
Yes.
Every believer is given a full plate
every day
on the plate.
Well,
there are many blessings, but that is also a burden or two.
All right.
As parents tell children, eat your vegetables.
Amen.
They are good for you. So does each person face the challenge of accepting life's full plate of burdens and blessing in full stride.
Yeah.
The African-American woman is more sensitive to this truth.
Yeah.
She has been served a plate with several distasteful items.
Well, all right.
But it is working out to be for her good. Women have difficult times, and it seems African-American women have a tough time.
Yeah.
We as women is up late every night,
yeah,
washing,
yeah,
vacuuming,
yeah,
cooking,
yeah,
changing diapers,
yeah,
helping with homework,
all right.
All that yelling and screaming,
yeah,
and you're never still a single minute in the day. But somehow we managed to gain 10 pounds. Amen? Women seem to have a full plate that always contains a whole lot of the bad stuff. Despite the distasteful item on the plate of the African-American woman, she has still managed to grow and succeed.
All right.
Beyond the expectation of many, even the bitter experience of her history have made her stronger, bolder, and more able. To stand in this perilous time, whether male or female, every life experience has a little rain sometimes. The beauty is that after the rain, the sun will shine. Christian women endure the rain because even in the storm, they know the sun, the S-O-N, will shine. As Christians, we have learned to take the bitter with the sweet that this life offers. Every believer has the joy of knowing that for every burden, there is also a blessing that comes from God.
Yeah.
This text focused on both a burden and blessing that God gave Eve. After Eve was given a great blessing from God in the beginning and dominion over the earth, both were invested with the sanction of heaven as they ruled God's creation. The blessing that God gave them in Genesis 1, 27 through 28 was never revoked or rescinded. It remains in force to this day.
All right.
Satan is interceding in the beginning and tempting Eve to sin. As a result of her sin, God placed an ended hater or strap between Satan and woman and her seed that would last many years. Now, as you know, we women go through some tough times. And once we carry a child 9 months, it's because of Eve that we be in so much pain. Today, there are many African-American women who are struggling with an Eve complex. They feel as though they are operating under a curse that cannot be revoked. Until recent years, it was almost unheard of in the black community that a mother would abandon their children. African-American women have in motherhood throughout our history. They have been an example of what the Bible calls a virtuous woman. Even in their worst states, motherhood is a burden that African-American women have borne with dignity and respect. Millions of women, even today, have placed their dreams on the back burner of life so that they might help their children. The new black woman is operating on a revised playing field. She is no longer expected to watch her dreams die.
All right.
She is no longer expected to walk behind a man. In fact, many are assuming the burden of raising a family without a man. There is one thing that women need that all women before her had. To have, she needs the power of God.
Yeah. Amen.
She may work in corporate America, but she still needs God. She may be a professional, clerical worker, bus driver, but she still needs God. Every woman here today should rip that page out of our history, if nothing else, and resolve, as for me and my house,
all right,
we will serve the Lord.
All right.
While God give us a certain number of burdens, believers have the consolation of knowing that we never have to deal with them alone. We have been isolated, but we were not alone. We have been frustrated, but we were not alone in our frustration. The woman of our past bowed low so that children today could stand tall. The women of our heritage did what they had to do so that we could do what we want to do. If we stay on the right path, God will be with us. Romans 8:31 tells us, if God be for us, who can be against us?
All right.
If we keep our hand in God's hand, blessing will overpower our troubles, and we will continue to rise. If our life was a credit report, and we were trying to obtain salvation based on our credit score, we wouldn't get it. Our history shows that we've been delinquent in our praise. Past worship and their intellectual. Hallelujah. And we missed a few payments. Our time. Or only pay half. You know, like putting $20 in the basket when it comes around, when we feel like we don't owe God a favor. Not to mention that our debt, our sins to income ratio is too high. But I thank God that we were able to file bankruptcy. And it cleared us of all our debts.
All right.
Now we have a co-sign of Jesus.
That's right.
Is faultless.
Yeah.
Not one blemish on his report. Praise God. So now we qualify for everything. Most important, we inherit eternal life. And we didn't have to put one penny down. All of our closing calls were covered when Jesus laid down his life for us. I hear that our future home has all of the upgrades to hardwood floors. Please, we'll be walking on gold. Thank you, Lord, for your unmerited mercy.
All right.
Thank you for your grace. And thank you, Lord, for your favor. Thank you, everyone, for listening. Be blessed.